Down Under. This is Thursday, 23rd of February, 2023. This morning, I went for a shave after my shower, and obviously you run the water, and you turn the hot tap on. Oh, get a little trickle. What's happened there? I'm thinking, oh, someone's turned the water off. And then I went to another tap, exactly the same 2 weeks ago. So cold water coming out. They haven't, because I thought, oh, if they stop the water, this cold will stop, and then the hot will eventually, empty the tank. But no, this washer failed 2 weeks ago and it come off. And today, see, no water. So what's happened the washer in that tap? These are brand new taps, been in maybe 2 months maximum. So I bought another set because I stupidly broke or bent the bar, the T-bar underneath. And so I took this back to the shop and the bloke says, well, we can't sell these because the pipe is bent. And I said, yeah, but you wouldn't want to sell them because the taps are failing within maybe 100 uses maximum. So I said, I want to upgrade to another set. So what he actually did was give me some brass washers with, they're better than the cheap things in these taps. So thanks to Murray TNH Hardware, whatever it's called, TMNH Hardware and Murray. But Mildon, sorry, I won't be buying your cheap products because I don't want to spend my time taking taps off and changing washers. You shouldn't have to do that. So I was talking about these taps earlier this morning and I'd basically said to the shop or the company that sells these taps, you're selling a product with defective washers in it. Yes, they'd already given me washers, but anyway, long story short, I got a phone call throughout the day and they said, bring back one set and we'll give you a full refund because you shouldn't have had to buy two sets to fix one. Anyway, by the time I changed that washer, that was fine. But when I went to undo this washer, it wouldn't budge. It just wouldn't. And it moved a tiny bit. And guess what happened? The T-bar underneath bent. So here we go again. So I went to the plumbers. And of course, this time the woman in the shop said, oh, the plumbers sell them. So I then went to the plumbers. I bought another T-bar. I also asked for taps so I don't have to turn it off outside and at the hot water system. So there's now taps, it's still flexies, I do copper if I could take all the walls apart and solder and all. But anyway, those are the new flexies and there's a new, I don't know if the camera can see this because I can't see the camera. So there is, anyway, it's a new T-bar going into the top, obviously with plumber's tape to make sure it doesn't drip. And for a few weeks, I'll keep this egg box in there because egg boxes show up any drips, but it's dry as a bone and I've labelled hot and cold. I could put blue tape, blue and red tape, I could have maybe even bought. So third time, so hopefully that's done now and it's not going to leak anymore. And hope the washers do feel different on the taps. They just feel completely different to the cheap things that were in there. So I'm very pleased with that. This is lined up because I made sure there was more tap coming up. This is slightly off, but anyway,